thankful for that. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her. And that right early. The heathen raged. The kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice. The earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease. Unto the end of the earth he breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. I'm going to talk just a few minutes this morning on God is our refuge. He is our strength. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, Hezekiah just became king. His dad, Ahaz, he was kind of a dirtbag. He didn't do what was right in the sight of God. He built a bunch of idols, a bunch of false gods, a bunch of false temples. He tore down the temple of God. It just wasn't good. And God said, you know what, Ahaz? Cities of Jericho, of Israel. Amen? Hezekiah was completely and totally different from Ahaz. He knew who God was. He knew how to worship God. He knew the right way to worship God, and he trusted God. He had his faith in God. As soon as Ahaz was dead, he said, we ain't doing this anymore. He tore down the false gods. He tore down the idols. He rebuilt the temple and instituted right worship.
Right.
And you see, there's a right way and a wrong way to worship God. Your dad burn right there he is. Amen? There's a right way and a wrong way to worship God. Hezekiah, he was just a man. He loved God. He knew who God was, and he was trying to do things that was right. Any of us ever failed? Once or twice? Oh, everybody do this. Okay, you're all breathing. That's good. I'll get ready to call 911, but we got a bunch of dead folks in the house. It was a joke. Calm down. What was that? Hallelujah. So, Hezekiah, he did something that was dumb. Mistake. And Hezekiah, he probably kind of slow like me, he told Ahaz he saw the armies and he knew Jerusalem was going to be next. And he went to the king of Assyria and said, I'll pay you. If you'll just withdraw your troops and leave Jerusalem alone, I'll pay you whatever you want. King of Assyria said, well, sure, why not? So he paid him a huge amount, and guess what? King of Assyria, he didn't withdraw his troops. Big shock there, right? I think sometimes our government should take root this lesson. You can pay Al-Qaeda whatever you want. They hate our guts. They are our enemy. Right? They want to see us dead. So you can pay them. Hey, King of Assyria, Hezekiah, he's your enemy. He hates you, and he hates your God. Right?
Right.
Folks, you have an enemy. Not Al-Qaeda. They're our enemy in the natural. But I'm telling you, you have a spiritual enemy. His name is Satan. And he hates your guts.
Right.
He wants to see you destroyed and dead. And the only reason he hasn't is because we have a God.
We have a God.
Amen. Yes. And if you think for 1 minute that you can get in bed, so to speak, with your enemy and be okay, you are fooling yourself.
Amen.
If you have one foot with the God of this world and one foot in the church, not going to happen. Amen. Don't let him fool you, church. He is your enemy, and he hates you. Hezekiah had an enemy. It was the king of Assyria. And he paid him. And, of course, Assyria double-crossed him. So Hezekiah, he's still a man of faith. He loves God, and he has his faith in God. He just messed up. So he gets his head on straight and said, okay, I'm going to do what I know to do. I'm going to rebuild the wall where it's been torn down. I'm going to build another wall around Jerusalem. I'm going to fortify it. I'm going to build towers on this wall so our guys can fight the enemy. Amen? He dries up. He sees the armies that are amassed around Jerusalem. He has the water cut off to the enemy. He does everything he can in the natural to help his cause. Sometimes we go to God and say, whoa, God, I'm in trouble. I've got this mess and that mess and the other mess and his mess and her mess and their mess. I've got it all. And we take it to God. And sometimes we have not done everything that we can do.
Amen.
Have we prayed about the situation? Have we fasted about the situation? Have we got on our knees and really cried out to God, God, I've got this situation and I need your help? Have we done that? Well, we might as well be real. Hezekiah did what he knew to do. He didn't just say, okay, God, I'm just going to sit back on my laurels and let you take care of this. But he said, I'm going to do what I know to do. And that's what he did. And then he encouraged the people. They saw the armies that were amassed. They lived under Ahaz, who was a heathen, and so they all turned into a bunch of heathens. And Hezekiah encouraged. He said, I see the armies. I know what they're up to. We've done what we can do. But now, I know a God that can do what we can't do. And we're going to put our faith and our trust in him. He is going to be our refuge. He's going to be our strength. What's a refuge? If you see a tornado headed this way, and you have a storm shelter, that's our refuge. And if you're not smart enough, so many times we'll set the tornado sirens off in Mount Vernon, and the first thing people do is open up the door and step out. And look, it's a tornado. You guys ever done that? Yeah, y'all laugh. Y'all laugh because you do the very same thing. But if you see the tornado coming and the sirens are going off and the wind's blowing and it's hailing golf ball size, don't go outside. Get in the shelter. Get in your refuge. Jesus is our refuge. Don't step out into the world to see the earthquake, to see the disaster. Read your newspaper. You can see the disaster that's going on. Amen? Well, Hezekiah strengthened the people with his words. That God is our refuge. God is our strength. God is going to take care of this situation. We've done what we can do, folks. God's going to take care of it now. And his words strengthen the people. And you know what? Nowhere in the New Testament have I read that promise. Right?
Amen.
It's for us.
Yes.
I haven't read it in the Old Testament where the Holy Ghost was going to be poured out, and that was only for the early church. Is it still for us?
Amen.
Are you still a bunch of tongue talkers?
Amen.
Are you holy rollers?
Amen.
I never rolled. That promise is for us. He is our refuge and our strength.
Amen.
And God will fight our battles. Now, put Psalms 46 and 1 back up. Jerusalem. He strengthened the people. Tell them God is our refuge and our strength. And trouble came. Moses did everything that God told him to do. And they were standing on the banks of the Red Sea. And Egypt was barreling down on them. Of the Lord. Trouble run around,
we fret, we worry, we stress, we lay awake at night over the trouble. And when God just says,
is our strength. Hallelujah. I know I got more to say. What other scripture did I give you? What? As soon as they rested themselves, as soon as they just quiet, God said, now, let me show you the God that you serve. He said, an angel, the Bible says, wiped out the army that was amassed in Jerusalem. And the king of Assyria ran. We've done what we know to be God. He is our strength. We all have weaknesses. We all have times of distress. I like to win.
Amen.
That's Everyone say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Everyone say, I'm thankful it wasn't love thy neighbor as thyself. Hallelujah. You ready to worship the Lord?
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. God is good. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Who are you?
Everybody said praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Lord.
Is our fish and chicken fry.
So
you don't want to miss that. And we're cooking a lot of food. We're bringing in a lot of fish and a lot of chicken and all the good stuff. The church will be furnishing fish and chicken and hush puppies to go with it and coleslaw to go with it. And we'll be furnishing the drinks. And so what we would like for you to bring is dessert and any sides that you would like to have if you were coming to my house to eat. That kind of a meal, what would you bring with it? So there you go. So, because that would be the polite thing to do if you were coming to my house. See, it was to help me out. So bring something, whatever it is that you would like. Come and let's just have a good time. Invite folks. It's a good time. People might not want to come to church just to hear me preach, but they'll come to eat fish and chicken. And we've got it all ready to go. And we're going to have a good time. So invite some folks to come with you. We'll have one service next week. Brother Marty Bryant will be here. And he will be singing and ministering in between songs and just whatever he has in mind. And we're planning on eating about 11:30. So come and let's have a good time in the Lord. We'll have it set up here where you can eat here, take it with you. But we're just going to have a real good time in the Lord. We're excited about it. We're believing God's going to do a great thing.
Yes.
And we'll have fishes and loaves. And we'll have a good time in the Lord. And we'll have fishes and loaves and